Rhys Darby joins us now from Sydney.
Thank you. Hello.
Welcome. I mean, this looks absolutely nuts. What was it about playing a pirate that you were keen on? Was it the pillaging? Was it the swashbuckling that lured you in? What was it?
I mean, it's everything, right? The inner child, just being able to play sword fights and get paid for it. I mean, yeah, all right. Sure, I'll do it.
We actually have been told we have some images of you playing a pirate on Sydney Harbour. Let's have a look at those right now, if we've got them. It's always good when you've been told we've got something.
Shots.
There we go.
Oh, promo shots. Oh,
oh,
look at that.
Look so
at home.
Oh,
GQ.
Yeah.
Oh, I love that suit too.
That's like a Vogue shoot.
Hot. I mean, this is very modern piracy, isn't it?
Oh, gosh. You know, when you're a styly guy, you've got to go with it. And that's just the way I roll, guys.
Well, it makes sense, actually, because I understand that your character was based on a real-life aristocrat. I just saw that you put this picture on your Instagram to reveal it to us. I hope we have this one. Yes, we do. Steed Bonnet. There you go.
Oh.
Barbadian planter-turned-pirate.
Yep.
And then, oh, hanged in Charleston. Oh, that didn't go well. Wait, did you just post a massive spoiler?
Yeah, that was a spoiler there. Look, he is a real guy, and it's an amazing story. It was over 300 years ago, but he is a wealthy aristocrat, landowner, had everything. He was married, had kids, but like people of that time, of that ilk, he really didn't want to carry on with that kind of life. He wanted a second chance, so he decided to become a pirate. It was a real midlife crisis.
Really?
Why wouldn't you?
Rhys, you have made us laugh for so many years now. I've had the opportunity to work with you. I've seen the Rhys Darby masterclass of acting. Your range is incredible, mate. But I'm wondering, when you're playing a pirate, where was the pirate accent? Did you consider doing, like, leaning into the whole "arr" thing?
See, this is where you've always gone wrong, mate. You know, you're going down with those usual tropes. It's hack. We're turning comedy on its heels. We're turning it round and we're focusing on the mundane of piracy. You know, those days when they're out at sea where there's no other ship in sight and they're just sort of looking at each other going, so what else? And Steed Bonnet, he's so extravagant because he brought all of his outrageous outfits with him, and then he built a library on the boat, okay? And this happened for real, and because he loved reading, he loved just, like, fantasizing about adventure, and he also paid his pirates a wage. It was ridiculous. He basically bought his way into this world, and, you know, obviously ended up dying.
You sound like someone who's had a lot of free time on your hands, which a lot of us have because of the pandemic. But when you were in New Zealand waiting it out, you actually launched your own talk show in your backyard, leading to the question, why?
You know, a rural chat show hadn't really been done. And so I was stuck on this property. It was my own, so that wasn't too bad. But I was with some friends, one of which was another actor. We also had another mate who was a camera operator. So we decided to just make a show. And it was also focusing on the rivalry between Aussies and Kiwis.
Ah. Will there be a second season, Rhys, or do you have to wait for another pandemic for that to happen?
It was a pandemic-only scenario. And, yeah, I don't know. I'd love to do it again. I'd love, you know, it was a lot of fun, but unfortunately I'm a pirate now.
You said a pandemic scenario and you'd love to do it again. Thanks, buddy.
Oh, no, not that! The show!
Oh, OK, all right. Well, I'm glad you clarified. One thing that we've seen that you do love is the Masked Singer, because you were on the guessing panel for the Kiwi Masked Singer, and you have got some moves. I mean, look
Hello.
At this.
Hello. Hello.
This is...
You need to teach Husey some.
Well, you know what they say, if you've got the moves, show them.
This show you're doing with Taika Waititi, who you've done so much with, he's the executive producer. When he calls, do you just answer the phone and just say, yeah, I'll do it, before you even know what it is?
Well, pretty much. I mean, we have the same sense of humour. We've kind of taken on the world of Hollywood as a small Kiwi group of people that really feel as though we're, you know, stepping outside of our comfort zone. And that's the Kiwi way, is to try and knock something off that most people think we wouldn't be able to pull off. And it's kind of a combination of confidence and, well, hey, well, a sense of humour.
It's brilliant, whatever it is. Our Flag Means Death premieres this Thursday, March 3rd on Binge. Rhys Darby, thank you very much.
Thank you.